We come to another lady who is Mehrunisa. Mehrunisa, her real name, but when she became a queen, then she became Nurjahan, the light of the universe. She was the daughter of a grand vizier, jiska naam tha Itmaduddaula. Sun naam to uska gaya Suddin tha. But when he became a minister, he was given the title of Itmaduddaula, that is the trust of the government. From the real name changed to Itmaduddaula from Ghiyasuddin. Ghiyasuddin was a kind of pauper, bilkul fukra sa tha, fukra, bilkul. Punjabi koi nahi hai. He was in Afghanistan. At that time it was Iran, at Kandahar. So jab gurbat bahut badh gayi, he thought he should go to India. Maybe he can get a job in the court of the Mughals. While he was traveling with his family and a few members of the group, so his wife was pregnant, and as soon they crossed into India, at that time it was India, the wife gave birth to a daughter, and that was the Mehrunisa. So baki logon ne kaha bhai ab to marriage choti si bachchi hai, to traveling karna mushkil hai, so you stay here for a couple of days or couple of weeks, and when everything is okay, so then you can join us in the meanwhile we move on. वो कहा बाकी काफिला अगर चला गया ये पीछे रह गए, बट अल्टीमेटली दे जॉइंड द काफिला एंड दे वर एबल टू रीच दिल्ली एंड अल्टीमेटली दे वेल हैड दे हैड एन अपॉर्चुनिटी टू कॉन्टेक्ट अकबर एंड ही गॉट अ जॉब देयर एंड अल्टीमेटली आफ्टर अकबर व्हेन जहांगीर केम इनटू पावर एंड देयर वाज अ कॉन्टेक्ट बिटवीन जहांगीर एंड नूरजहां. Now here the story is different. The story we learn from one source is that Jahangir fell in love with Nurjahan much before she was married to Sher Afghan, because Akbar was against this marriage, considering that Nurjahan or Mehrunisa belonged to a very ordinary family, so she was not fit for the royal family. So Akbar ne uske saath zabardasti Sher Afghan ke saath kar di and sent Sher Afghan to Bengal as a governor of Bengal. वो नूरजहां वहाँ चले गए एंड देन जहांगीर प्लान टू किल शेर अफगन एंड अल्टीमेटली ही मैनेज टू किल शेर अफगन एंड देन ही वांटेड टू मैरी नूरजहां बट नूरजहां रिफ्यूज फॉर थ्री मंथ्स फॉर थ्री इयर्स शी वाज पुट इन जेल. अच्छा शादी नहीं करती तो मैं तुम्हें जेल में डाल देता. बट देन द गुड आइडिया केम टू हर माइंड कि जेल में रहने से बेहतर है शुड बिकम क्वीन ऑफ इंडिया. सो शी एग्रीड एंड द मैरिज टू प्लेस. And ultimately, she became the Empress of India. That is one. The other story says that after the marriage, when she was a married woman, Jahangir fell in love with her. Jahangir ka to kuch pata nahi kab shuru ho jaye uska to married woman ke saath usne. And according to uske Jahangiri, to uske Jahangiri mein to Akbar in uske Jahangiri, that is the biography of Jahangir. He says that the woman when she is married, that is the real prime of her life. जो उसकी उस वक्त खूबसूरती होती है वो कब उससे पहले नहीं हो सकती. So he was infatuated. Infatuation है इतने कि आप ऐसा love है इसको आप control ही ना कर सकें. So the marriage was the result of this infatuation. So that is the story. The two aspects or two version of the love story between Jahangir. नूरजहां वाज़ अ वेरी वर्सेटाइल पर्सन. वेरी वर्सेटाइल. उसने अरक गुलाब भी बना दिया, उसने समोसा भी बना दिया, उसने सलीम शाही जूती भी बना दी, उसने एम्ब्रॉयडरी के बहुत से डिजाइन भी बना दिए, एंड शी वाज़ अ पोएटिस एंड अ राइटर आल्सो. सो ऑब्वियसली बीइंग सो इंटेलिजेंट शी बिकेम द एम्प्रेस. एंड फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम इन द हिस्ट्री ऑफ द मुगल्स कॉइन्स वर इश्यूड इन द नेम ऑफ अ क्वीन. उससे पहले जो कॉइन्स होते थे उस पर सिर्फ बादशाह का नाम होता था. But it was first time that coin bore the name of the Empress Nurjahan also. 2 years after Akbar died and Selim became emperor, Sher Afghan met his death. However, 3 more years were to pass before a grieving Nurjahan consented to marrying Emperor Jahangir. This story I have told you. According to the Dutch traveler Paul said, her patronage of architecture was extensive. She erects very extensive buildings in all directions, sarais or halting places for travelers and merchants, and pleasure gardens and palaces such that no one has ever seen before. In 1620, Noor Jahan commissioned a large sarai in Jalandhar district, which is known as Sarai Noor Mahal. In local idiom, meant some suspicious and important figure. Noor Mahal itni badi sarai thi ki koi imagine nahi kar sakta tha. There itni badi sarai bhi ho sakti hai. But the main construction of the caravanserai took place on the route from the capital, that is Agra or Delhi, to Lahore, and then from Lahore to Srinagar. That was the main route of our sarais. But at the same time, she built a number of caravanserai which were toward Kabul. And one of her most important caravanserai is still situated at the bank of river Indus. When you are moving by road from Islamabad to Peshawar, as soon as you reach Indus River, before touching the river, on the left side, this is a high wall. You can always observe this high wall. This high wall is a boundary wall of this caravanserai. This caravanserai was known and is still known as Begum Ki Sarai. You can visit this sarai anytime you like. This is one of our sarais on the route to Kashmir. And this is the Mughal road on which the caravans used to travel. And this is also known as this station, this halting place was known as Peer Ki Gali. And the road is known as the Mughal road. So we have 10 minutes still, and this is the picture of the Noor Mahal. Just look at the gateway. If you look at the gateway around, it gives you the idea how massive or how impressive this building of this caravanserai would have been at the time when it was functioning. This is the interior. This gateway is showing the exterior. And this is the interior. And look at the number of doors and rooms and rooms and rooms. And in Lahore, we have a caravanserai of Akbar also. If you go to Jahangir's tomb, before you reach the Jahangir's tomb, there is a huge courtyard. Huge, huge courtyard. Uske charon taraf bhi is tarah kamre hain. That is known as Akbari Sarai. Some of the people say it is not Akbari Sarai. Some of them say it is Noor Jahan, sorry, Shah Jahani Sarai. Whatever the case be, without doubt, that caravanserai is that of the Mughals. Usme bhi aise kamre hain aur beshumar kamre. But during the time of the British, jab wo railway line bicha rahe the, and then they were laying the road, sorry, the railway line between Lahore and, let's say, Wazirabad or Gujarat or in the north of the country. So they built a railway station which is known as Shadra Station. The Shadra was a junction. What is a junction? Junction kya cheez hai?
सेंटर पॉइंट होता है जहां पर सारी सड़कें आपस में मिलती हैं, वो जंक्शन होता
है। जंक्शन उस जगह कहते हैं, जैसे कि जैसे हम लाहौर से चले तो अगर हम पहुंच जाए गुजरात और गुजरात से आगे खा रही हैं, सीधा चले जा रहे हैं, कोई रास्ते में और सड़क नहीं निकलती, तो वो तो सड़क जंक्शन ना हुआ। लेकिन हम अगर जैसे लाहौर से निकल के हम जाए गुजरांवाला, तो गुजरांवाला में से एक सड़क सीधा वजीराबाद जा रही है, लेकिन एक सियालकोट भी जा रही है। तो यहाँ से इस तरह के रूट्स नए निकल आते थे, दैट पॉइंट वाज नोन एज अ जंक्शन। दैट एप्लीकेशन ऑफ दिस टर्मिनोलॉजी आल्सो अप्लाइड टू द रेलवे स्टेशंस। द शदरा वाज अ जंक्शन बिकॉज यहाँ से एक रेलवे लाइन गुजरांवाला तो जाती जाती थी, एक लाइन शेखुपुरा भी जाती थी और एक लाइन नारोवाल भी जाती थी। सो इट वॉज अ बिग जंक्शन। बिकॉज ऑफ द बिग जंक्शन यहाँ रेलवे इंजन्स को अपने इंजनों के लिए कोयले चाहिए होते थे। तो अंग्रेजों ने क्या किया, दे कंस्ट्रक्टेड ए रेलवे लाइन फॉर शदरा जंक्शन इन टू द कैरवानसराय ऑफ द जहांगीर टूम। और जहांगीर की टूम के अंदर रेलवे लाइन ले गए और सराय के जितने कमरे हैं उनका कोल डेपो बना दिया। सो रेलवे इंजन अंदर जाते थे और कोल लेके वापस आ जाते थे। इफ यू गो टू दिस कैरवानसराय इवन टूडे, तो आप कैरवानसराय के दूसरी साइड पर निकल जाए, so you will still see the surviving part of the railway line. So main gate pe agar aap dekhen to chhat ke upar aapko engine ke dhuye ke nishan ab bhi nazar aate hain. So this is how they treated our monuments, but ultimately thodi unko jab akal aa gayi to then they removed that railway line from here and they built a separate storage for the coal. तो ये नूर महल के कुछ और नक्शा देख लें आप, और बिग कैरावान साइज। दिस इज द डिटेल ऑफ द गेट हाउस, द प्रोजेक्टिंग विंडोज, एंड देन द मेन आर्च, एंड देन द सब्सिडी आर्च, एंड देन द मेडलियंस, एंड देन द गैलरी, एंड द गैलरी, एंड द साइड्स ऑफ दिस। दिस इज नॉर्मल टाइप ऑफ द गेटवेज, द हाउस, एंड द डेकोरेटिव एलिमेंट्स, द गैलरी स्टैंडिंग ऑन द ब्रैकेट्स which has the pendentives at the bottom, and then some carvings, decoration, vases, and the holder of those vases or the paradot, etc. And then some portion of this great caravanserai today in this condition, some of the patient portion in this condition. And then I was talking to you about the Begum Ki Sarai. This is the Attic Fort. Part of the Attic Fort, not whole of it. It's a huge fort, huge, huge fort, built by Akbar. The idea was to defend it from the enemy coming from the Kabul side. So the boundary line was the river, served as the boundary line. But when we see this caravanserai from the high point, the caravanserai looks like this. Beautiful place. This is now under the occupation of Pakistan Army. This condition looks bad here, but some of the portion of this have been restored. That is better condition than this. In the middle, there is a building here. This is the mosque of the caravanserai. Beautiful location. And last time I visited this, about a year ago, when we climbed up to this level, jahan log traveler raat ko upar chadke chhat pe sote the, beautiful breeze you enjoy over the roof of this caravanserai. And this is a Google picture. This is the road, the new road, the M1 or whatever it is. And this is the river. And as soon as you river, this is the location of the Begum Ki Sarai. Very important location and a very beautiful location as well. Then come to another Noor Jahan Ki Sarai in Sadabad, in Bimber, in Pakistan. There's a very bad condition. This is another picture of the same Sarai. And the wall of the same Sarai. And the interior of the same Sarai. And then there is another fortress, which is known as Doraha. Doraha bhi ek kisam ka junction hai in Ludhiana in India. And there also exists a Mughal Sarai. It is also known as Doraha or Doraha Sarai. It is located at Doraha in Ludhiana district, popularly known as Mughal Caravan Sarai. So ye uska ek one of the tower of the gatehouse. And this is the main tower of the gatehouse. And this is walking toward the... This is the back of the gatehouse, and we walk in. This road leads to the main caravanserai. This is the sign over there. It says this Mughal fort, caravanserai of the Mughal time. And the same condition, the chambers and the gatehouse with all the offices located here. And some detail of the same building and the massive construction or massive area of this caravan sarai. Then there is a Dakhni Sarai. Dakhni means the sarai which is in the south. For example, we have Hyderabad in Pakistan, and there is a Hyderabad in India also. So Hyderabad in India was known as Hyderabad Dakhan. Dakhan means south. So Dakhni is actually Dakhan. In the south is located 25 kilometers away from Jalandhar. It consists of 124 cells around close courtyard. The Sarai is named after the village in its location. It is said that the Sarai was built by the well-recognized Mughal noble, Ali Mardar Khan, and he built it at the time when Mughal Emperor Shah Jahan was in power in 1640. Ali Mardar Khan is same, whose tomb is situated in Lahore, near or inside the Mughal railway workshop. And he is the same person who is responsible for the hydraulic system of the Shalimar Gardens. And he is the one of those person jisne loto ki buniyad rakhi. Loti aap samajhte hain na, jo apne party badal lete hain. He was governor of Kandahar with the Herat government. To usne raaton raat apne jo tabedari thi wo Shah Jahan ke saath kar li, aur Kandahar sara Shah Jahan ke wale kar diya usi chakkar mein. To ye bahut bada lota tha, isne lotaism ki buniyad rakhi. But when he became a lota of Shah Jahan, obviously he became a kind of minister and a very popular person. And when he will introduce the hydraulic system of the Shalimar Bagh, he was awarded with a lot of money. So, bada rich aadmi tha ye. And uska tomb agar aap dekhe, it's surviving in Lahore. And this is yet another caravanserai in India. Iska naam hai Sarai Sadullah. This location is somewhere near Amritsar. Sarai Amanat, I'm sorry for this misinformation. Sarai Amanat was built by the Mughals as a caravanserai resting place on the Grand Trunk Road in a small village south of Amritsar. Not much is known about Amanat Khan except that he was a royal calligrapher of immense repute. And that is the gatehouse of the Sarai Amanat Khan. And that is the inner part of the back part of the gatehouse. And the mosque within the caravanserai. And the most important thing is, you would see low arches, very low arches. Even these arches are very low. So sanctuary has very low arches. This is the closer detail of the same arches. Very interesting. And some tile work is still surviving. And some inscriptions are also still surviving, but in a very, very bad shape. In front of the verandas of the caravanserai and the entrance to the chamber is very nice. And you can see the arches, very, very rigid, very thick kind of construction that lacks delicacy. Maybe at that time the builders were not very expert, that's why. So, and nevertheless, the veranda is quite spacious, but the entrance is very low entrance here and very low entrance here. Reason is not known. A part of the area which has been destroyed and part of the area which has been reconstructed. So you can see the flight of steps going up to this. Now coming to Pakistan, we have a knowledge. We have a knowledge of ek sarai ko to maine aapko bata diya jo Jahangir ke tomb ke bahar hai sarai Akbari sarai ya Shahjahani sarai. We have talked about this. But then in Lahore, while we are traveling from Gujarat to Jhelum, before we reach River Jhelum, there is a small locality which is known as Sarai Alamgir. The historians suggest, or we believe, that when Aurangzeb Alamgir was ruling, and most of the time he used to travel to Kabul, he constructed a caravanserai at this place. And because of his name, the Sarai became known as Sarai Alamgir. This Sarai doesn't exist today, albeit the name of the Sarai Alamgir survives. Now the Sarai Alamgir is a halting place or a small station, but the Sarai building is missing. Then when we come to Lahore, we learn that there is a Sarai Sultan and there is a Sarai Dara, two Sarais in Lahore, close to the railway station. So while I was standing trying to find out the location of Sarai Sultan, I found out, but some of the people also told me that Sarai Sultan and Sarai Dara actually one and the same thing. The real name of the Sarai Sultan was Sarai Sultan Dara, because Dara, who was the son of Shah Jahan, he was a lover of Lahore. He was a lover of Lahore because his saint, uska jo peer of murshid the, Hazrat Mia Mir Sahib, he belonged to Lahore. So Dara Shiko used to come to Lahore very often. So he loved Lahore, the city of Lahore, so much so that he imported a lot of red sandstone and marble from India to Lahore, from the rest of India, let's say, to Lahore, in order to build a huge mausoleum of Hazrat Mia Mir Sahib. But since he was arrested and put in jail by his younger brother, Aurangzeb, so usko wo construction ka mauka nahi mila. But since a lot of material, red sandstone and marble, was lying in wilderness, so Aurangzeb ne socha ki ye material zaya nahi hona chahiye. So he ordered the construction of a mosque. The mosque, was, when it was built, or during the time of the British, the mosque was known as Red Mosque, Lal Masjid. Ye Lal Masjid wahi hai. which is now known as Shahi Masjid of Lahore. So because it was built of red sandstone, तो शुरू में इसे लाल मस्जिद ही कहते थे, अंग्रेज भी इसे रेड मॉस्क कहते थे, बट नाउ द रेड मॉस्क लाल मस्जिद ऑफ मेकअप इस्लामाबाद में है, नॉट हियर, हियर इट इज द शाही मस्जिद. सो सुल्तान सराय सुल्तान एंड सराय दारा वन एंड द सेम थिंग. एंड देन बिहाइंड द व्हाट इज दैट म्यू हॉस्पिटल ऑन द बांसावाला बाजार साइड, इफ यू गो बैक ऑफ द back of this new hospital, there is an area which is known as Sarai Ratan Chand. When I was a young person, not young person, I was boy, 11, 12 years old, I remember there used to be a bus station there. वहाँ से बसें जाते थे पिंडी को और इधर उधर. So I often used to go to Sarai Ratan Chand because it was a bus station also. वहाँ से मैं बस लेता था पिंडी जाने के लिए. My sister was in Pindi. तो हाँ बड़ी बहुत सराय थी. इट वॉज इन बैड शेप बट नेवरदलेस इट वॉज देयर. अब तो शायद वो भी नहीं रही. तो दैट वॉज द सराय रतन चंद. हु वाज रतन चंद? नॉट मच इज नोन अबाउट रतन चंद. नाउ टॉकिंग अबाउट द सराय सुल्तान, दिस इज सराय सुल्तान गेटवे एंड दिस इज द जीटी रोड कमिंग फ्रॉम अमृतसर एंड गोइंग देयर एंड देन टर्निंग हियर, दिस इज दिल्ली गेट एंड सराय सुल्तान इज रेलवे स्टेशन इज हियर. एंड इफ यू गो टू रेलवे स्टेशन यू इजीली फाइंड, यू कैन इजीली फाइंड वेयर द Sultan Sarai, Sarai Sultan is. So Sarai Sultan and the Sarai Sultan Dara, one and the same thing. So here, these areas, I'm sure you know these areas, Faizbagh, Sultanpura, Swaminagar, railway station, and Ramgali. Ramgali is a very famous area. Then the Delhi Gate. And so the Sarai Sultan is here. This is your Linda Bazaar. And so easy to find this. It is at the junction of two roads. This is the larger map of the same area. This is the road coming here, and this is the surrounding areas of this. Mr. Shah is here, Farooq Ganj is here, Gali Pranavali is here, Chota Mufti Bakar is here, and then Ramgali, and then Sarai Sultan over here. So this is the position, and this is the story of various caravanserais of the Abbasids and of the Mughals. And this brings us to the end of today's lecture. And now